What makes a teenage marriage a success or a failure? I'm Sue Sklar from Evergreen Park High School, and we'll be looking at both sides of this question today on Wrap It Up. Divorce Conciliation Service of the Circuit Court of Cook County, one out of every two teenage marriages ends in divorce. Yet in Cook County alone in 1974, over 16,000 young people still in their teens got married. Today on Wrap It Up, we'll be taking a closer look at why teenagers got married and what it takes to make that marriage work. Although every marriage is unique and has its own special reason for success or failure, we've invited two young people here today to give us a little more insight into teenage marriage. Terri Murray has been married for 2 years. Both she and her husband were 18 when they got married. And Camille Lissy was also married when she was 18. She's now 23 and has been divorced for a year and a half. Our panelists today are Curtis Rogers, Vice President of the Drama Club at Harlan High School, Cheryl Kettler, Varsity Debater at Elk Grove High School, Mike Wagner, Associate Editor of the Quigley South High School newspaper, and Celeste Zwissiel, President of the National Honor Society at Madonna High School. We'll begin our questions on teenage marriage right after this message. And Curtis Rogers has the first question today.
Yes, Terri, what did you expect out of marriage, and did marriage meet up to your expectations?
Well, I expected a fulfilling relationship. I expected to do things together and to have fun doing them and enjoy my husband. And yes, that's fulfilled my expectations very much.
What about you, Camille? What was your expectations of marriage, and did it meet up to your expectations?
No, it didn't, when I look at it now. At the time, I expected a compatible relationship and not a lot of fun, of course, but just someone that I could get along with and have a nice, mature relationship with.
Did you feel that at that age you were capable of not only supporting yourselves, but also managing to live on your own? Because you got married when you were still at the teenager level.
Did I feel that I was capable of living on my own when I got married? Probably not, no.
What social problems did you have when you got married? Or did you have any?
Not really too many. My husband was 5 years older than myself, so as far as money problems or family pressures, it really wasn't too bad.
Camille, why do teens get married? Why do you think they get married so young?
Why do I think other people get married?
Teens get married so young.
That's really hard for me to answer. I would say probably because they think they're doing the right thing at the time.
Terri, do you think that pregnancy is a valid reason for getting married, or do you think there has to be a bigger reason?
A much bigger reason. I would not get married and be forced into a marriage because of a pregnancy. I've known people that would either keep their child or put them up for adoption unless the couple has been planning on getting married.
What do you think, Camille?
I really agree. I wouldn't get married if I were pregnant. Definitely not.
Terri, how old were you when you were married, and how old is your husband?
We were both 18 when we got married.
And what about you, Camille?
I was 18. He was 23.
Well, did the age difference from 18 to 23 have any bearing on your relationship with your husband?
It might possibly have, yes, because I changed an awful lot.
Did you feel that you passed up a lot of the freedoms that other people your age were able to encounter at
yes.
that age?
Yes.
Is there any suggestion you give to young people who are getting married who are passing up these same freedoms? What would you tell them to do in order to get out of that rut?
It would depend on what they felt personally, you know. Trying to think. My biggest hang-up was finding that I was tied down with one person at 18 years old, and I wanted to experience different people, and you just can't do that.
Terri, do you feel that you've missed anything?
Not really, no. I've gone out quite a bit beforehand, and I had gone out with other people while I was going out with Mike in the beginning, and it just kind of grew into a relationship where I wanted to be with just him, and I really didn't care after that, and I think that's why it's worked out.
Was it tough for you to make the transition from dating steadily to a marriage level? Was it a problem? I mean, was it any kind of a rough transition period there?
Not with me, because it was a very gradual transition. I was informally engaged for about 2 years.
Well, Camille, were you involved in other people while you met your husband?
Yes, I dated him for 4 years before I was married.
And no one else?
No.
No one else except him?
No, that's incorrect. I dated him for 4 years while I was going, well, I was going with him for 4 years, and while I was dating him, I also went out with other people at the same time.
And you felt that because of your longing relationship that it led up to marriage?
Kind of seemed like the thing to do at the time, yeah. Sometimes you don't think too clearly. Hindsight's a great thing that we have, but we can't use it until after we've made mistakes.
Terri, did your parents have any influence on your decision to get married, since both of you were at the same age of 18?
My parents had very little to do with it at all.
You think that parents should have something to do with it?
Possibly discouraging their kids if they can see something that their kids cannot, but generally I think parents should stay out of it, because kids are gonna go ahead and do what they want. I know that's the way I handled it.
Well, Camille,
any difficulties being underage as far as alcohol goes and signing
for
a house?
Oh, quite a few. It's very embarrassing, because we had a lot of married friends
right.
who were well over 21, and to sit there and be carded
right.
when your friends are buying alcohol, that was very embarrassing at times.
Well, that was a problem. How did you get over the barricade?
I ordered a lot of 7-Up, put on a lot of makeup, tried to order beer.
Is there a problem when you went, for example, for a job and you have qualifications?
Yes.
Other people your age that were?
I tried getting a job. When I first got married, I decided I'm going to quit my job. I'm going to be a good housewife. And, you know, it seemed to go along with marriage. So I went out looking for a job later on, and I got a lot of funny looks from people. They were asking me why I wasn't in school and all of these things, or did I want part-time help, all these little insinuations that I was not a full-time, you know, available for full-time work.
What made you decide to get a job instead of being a nice little housewife?
Sitting around at home watching TV and knitting and painting.
Natural difficulty, or what was the problem?
Pardon?
Were there financial difficulties there, or was it just that
not at the time, no. No, mostly it was, like I said, difference in schedules. I would sit at home, and at evening I'd want to go out, and my husband would be working, say, 10 hours a day, and he'd want to sit down in front of the TV, and that was where our first little difficulty started.
Well, do you think that if you had waited on getting married a couple of years and went on and finished through school, if that was your plans before you got married, that you would be financially able now, or be more equipped to go out there and survive in this world today?
At the time when I was looking for a job, I thought that I should have maybe gotten some school, or should be going to school then.
But now that's not your feeling?
No, I have a very good job and excellent career opportunities, and I've only had 2 college courses. And
well, Camille, did you feel that you was missing education when you was married?
At the time when I encountered the same experience when I first went out looking for jobs, you do get typecast sort of in the housewife role. You know, they feel they can underpay you, or you just want 20 hours work a week. And I too now am very happily employed, and you know, having a good time of it.
This is puzzling me. She said that her parents had nothing to do with her marriage, and that parents would be like a burden if they did. Well, do you think that the parent, if they had anything, any say-so to do with your marriage, or had anything to do with it, do you think that it would have bettered your marriage, or maybe you would have survived the marriage?
No, I don't think so. My mother and I are quite close, and we had quite a few talks about it, and you really basically do what you want. I do, at least.
Did she encourage you to get married, or did she take the opposite side?
She was kind of noncommittal, actually. She pointed out both pros and cons and pointed out the fact that I was awfully young. Mm-hmm. And I suppose if she were kind of nasty, she could say, I told you so now, but...
Did you consider perhaps living together without the legal bind of marriage?
I think so, yeah.
Why did you take that road instead of the road with marriage?
I'm sorry, I misunderstood you. I thought you meant now or
future. Okay,
you mean then? No, not then. I didn't feel comfortable with that.
What about you, Terri?
I wouldn't have felt very comfortable either.
Yeah,
especially since I wanted a permanent relationship anyway.
Were your parents against that, or?
Pardon?
Was that because of a parental conflict, or was it just because it was against your moral standards?
Well, my upbringing, which is part of your moral standards, yes. But mostly it was because I wanted a permanent relationship, and I was asked.
But this is a quite personal question. I was wondering, what religion are you? What religion are you?
Christian.
Is your husband a Christian, too?
I believe so, yes.
There's different breeds. Like, when you got married, was he a Protestant and you're a Catholic, or... Was your ex-husband a Protestant
No, we were both of the same religion at the time we were married.
So you all didn't have any religious problems?
No, I think my personal experience has been that I've become a lot more my own person since I think, matured some. For me, I grew so much more between 18 and 22 than I ever thought possible.
Do you regret that decision you made back then?
What decision?
Making the marriage move back then, because you've divorced yourself since then. Do you think that you'd have been smarter not to have gotten married at all?
No, I feel it was a very helpful learning tool. I really do. I learned a lot through that.
Would you suggest that to other people our age who are considering it, even though they're not too sure?
Getting married or going ahead and seeing what happens?
Right.
I think I'd go ahead. You know, there's no way you can avoid a mistake.
Camille? We talked earlier about whether or not it was advisable to get married because you were pregnant. Mm-hmm. Do you think that if you'd had children, that would have had any effect on your decision to get a divorce?
It probably would have made it more difficult, but for me, I don't think it would have stood in my way, no.
But do you think that a person that is pregnant should go ahead and get married or just wait a while and see what happens?
You mean just using the pregnancy as the only basis for the marriage?
Right.
I would say if you're hoping that that's going to save it, no.
I'm sorry, we're going to have to cut in now for a message, and we'll be back in just a minute. Cheryl was just asking how a pregnancy can affect a teenage marriage.
Terri, I was wondering, now that you've been married for a few years, do you think that if you had had a child in those early years, it might have stifled either your economic growth or your ability to go out and do things that you had to get done?
It definitely would have put a clamp on that, for sure. I wouldn't have the career opportunities that I do and the educational opportunities, and I know it would have affected my husband. I don't think he would have wanted the extra responsibility at the time because we were still enjoying ourselves.
Do you have children now?
No, we don't.
Do you think the kids will interfere with your marriage in the future if you have children?
No, I think they'll be an asset if we wait for the right time. I think they'll be great.
Do you have any children?
No, I don't.
You don't.
Terri, how were you able to cope with the allegations of marriage right in the very beginning?
I didn't really have to cope too much because I was being supported by my husband. If I had dinner ready on time, that was great. Ready to go out in the evening.
Maybe you were too dependent on your husband?
The first few months, yes, until I decided I finally wanted to go out and get a job and have some responsibility.
Do you advise other young married couples to both get jobs so that they can, say, expand their outlook and not get stuck at home or something?
Very much so. I would tell anybody that got married to, provided they didn't have children, to both go out and get a job.
Camille, do you think dependency on one person is exactly what a person should have? Like to depend on just one person as you did with your...
I don't think that's possible. I don't understand how you could expect one person to fulfill all the needs of a personality, you know?
Mm-hmm. So you're saying that dependency is not advisable then, right? In your opinion?
A certain amount of dependency I don't think can be avoided, but I think a mature relationship rather than an adolescent relationship is what
that,
you should strive
you was,
for.
One of the reasons of you breaking up with your husband was due to dependency. Felt she was getting too dependent on him for your social life, economical outlook.
At first I felt that way, but when I finally decided to get divorced, I don't think I could have had that feeling at the time. Otherwise, I don't think I would have done it if I had been that dependent on him at that time.
Well, I could direct this question at both of you. Very briefly, what advice would you give to other young people now that are my age or even younger that are considering marriage? What steps should they take in testing their relationship out before they make the move?
Terri?
Well, for one, I believe that they should get to know each other for more than, say, a period of 6 months, which sometimes seems pretty standard. I think that there's a period of a few years involved. I think that they should feel free to go out with other people or go out with other groups of people and not always be together. I think that that idea can be a little harmful because then you do get too dependent on one person rather than exploring your possibilities.
Camille?
How about you, Camille?
What
do you feel?
I have pretty much the same opinion. It's important that you feel comfortable together and that you feel comfortable apart. If you don't trust your partner, that could be
what's
a lot
what's
of
a good test of seeing if you're comfortable with each other? Just going out steadily or occasionally? Or what do you think would be a good way of judging a good relationship?
I
it's
really
just
can't
experience
honestly
over
answer
a period
that.
Of time? Or what?
How did you judge yours, Camille?
How did I judge
yeah,
mine?
How did you consider yourself prepared to make the big plunge?
I felt I cared enough about the person at the time to spend, at that time, the rest of my life with them. It's very difficult for me to think back to my feelings, you know, that far. I'm really far removed from that now.
Is it always an individual decision then? There is no means to gauge it by except by an individual relationship?
I would say yes.
My opinion on marriage, I feel that if a person is mature enough to handle it and is capable to cope with all the problems that marriage arise and really, you know, likes the person and loves the person as Terri does, I know, to her husband, I think it's okay. But yet still, if a person can't cope with the problems, you know, that marriage arises, once you have to look at both sides of the situation. I was wondering, Camille, did you actually look at both sides of the problem?
At the time, I thought I did, yes. I went over problems about money or social pressures. But when you want to do something, you tend to make excuses in your favor. And I think that's what I did at the time.
Camille, now that you're divorced, what are the basic differences between marriage and divorce? Do you feel freer and more able to do what you've always wanted to?
I'm very happy now, yes. I don't have to be home at a certain time and get dinner on the table, and I can go away for a weekend and spend as much time as I want with my friends. Friends are very important to me now, even more so than when I was married.
Terri, do you feel stifled, you know, stuck in your little box, or do you feel
no,
fine?
No, I feel great. Like I say, I've got a job with a nice company. I work a full week on Saturdays, and I go to school, and I still have time for my husband. So it's very enjoyable right now. I like it very much.
So you're saying that your life is fulfilled at this moment?
Very much so, yes. I feel responsible, too, for the first time, because right now my husband's in a new position, and he's not making as much as he was at his other job, and now I've got the financial burden. Mm-hmm. And I can say right now it hasn't affected our relationship at all. He's been very nice about the whole thing, and it doesn't hurt him, and it doesn't make me feel awkward or funny that I'm doing the major job of supporting right now.
Camille, did many of your friends get married early as you did?
I'd say it was about half and half.
Camille, you're from a large family?
5 children.
Do you think that this is just a hypothesis? I have a theory that sometimes people who come from large families may have lost a lot of the attention people who come from smaller families have. Do you think that was your case, that was one of the reasons you got married, to perhaps attract more attention from one individual?
It's a possibility. I don't feel that that was true at the time, though. No.
Looking back on it, was that a definite thing with you? I mean, because you came from a larger family.
Well, as far as losing attention, I would say no. I'm the oldest in the family, and we have a nice family relationship.
Terri, is this the case with you also? Do you come from a large family?
Well, I come from a family of 4, and my husband comes from a family of 5. I'm the oldest one, too.
Camille, in your former marriage, did you allow each other to be individuals? I mean, like, was there a certain amount of caressing and loving and, you know, encouraging each other to be himself?
I'd say at first, yes, but then there was the breakdown. This is something that I learned. What I mentioned before, it was a tool to learn by. There's a lot of things I think I can avoid in the future by being able to see the mistakes that I've made.
What suggestions do you have for people who are married now? I mean, are there some kind of warning signs that they should watch out for?
I think a communication breakdown is a big warning sign.
And so if, as long as you're communicating and understanding each other's position, then there shouldn't be as big a problem.
Yes, and there's a difference between listening to someone and hearing them.
Do you agree, Terri?
Very much so. Every once in a while we have a nice long talk.
Do you have any arguments with your husband now, Terri?
Very few. Most of them stem from the fact that I told him I'd be home at 5 and I came in at 6 or 7 or 8.
Being individual.
That's my individual problem.
But do you think that arguments in a married relationship, is that normal or is that good or does that lead to...
It can be healthy if you get down to the real argument. If you say, like me, if I get upset because my husband doesn't pick up his clothes or something like that, that's not the real problem. I think it's something like if you talk about you have enough respect for somebody that you'll make the job easier on them by doing this for somebody that you love. And when you stop doing things special for somebody you love, then I think that's the real problem, not little superficial things.
Camille, did you have any arguments with your former husband?
Oh, yes.
And were they major or were they minor, such as Terri's arguments, like picking up the clothes, petty stuff that, you know, builds up to anxiety, so to say?
They start with petty things. And that's where the communication breakdown comes in. You don't get down to the real problem, like Terri said, and things just get worse from there.
I'm sorry, but we're going to have to break now for a message. Discussing some of the problems that teens encounter when they marry. And Mike, would you continue the questioning, please?
Yeah, I have one general question to sort of sum things up to direct to both of you. Do you feel that emotional maturity is more important at the age of 18 or whatever than, say, just an age maturity type thing? You know, being a certain age is more important than your emotional development. And what would you suggest to our people who are at that age?
Well, I think your emotional development is the most important. Your age really has not very little to do with it. It depends on how well you can handle things that come up and not panic or run away.
Were you emotionally mature for marriage at that age?
I felt I was.
Honestly,
I still do.
Okay. How about you, Camille? What do you think?
At the time I felt I was. Now I realize I wasn't.
Well, if it isn't a matter of age maturity, what about people who get married while they're still in high school? Do you think that has an effect on the later success or failure of the marriage, Camille?
Possibly, but if they're extremely emotionally mature and they have a real good relationship and if they do grow together, it should work.
And Terri?
I feel that the only big problem with that would be that it tends to separate people from your classmates. you were different.
So you have to get high school out of your system.
I think so.
I know we have a lot more questions that we could ask, but we're going to have to close the questioning now. And thank you, Terri Murray and Camille Lissy, for being here and sharing some of your ideas with us today. And to our panelists, Curtis Rogers, Cheryl Kettler, Mike Wagner, and Celeste Lisiel. And thank you for being with us today. We hope to see you again next week on Wrap It Up.